They got through it. I got through it. I think they'd have preferred a nice pink-faced marquis with a grouse more in the Scottish borders. Are you sure you wouldn't have preferred one of those, someone with a grand title, rather than a homeless Charlie Crown?
No.
Oh.
That would have all been very antiseptic.
We're a dying breed, you and I. Oh, I'm sure everyone will carry on pretending all is well. But the party's over. The good news is that while Rome burns and the temple falls, we will sleep, dearie, sleep.
Oh, you looked.
Yes. A piper's lament. Your sole musical choice. It's very you.
And your coffin being driven in an old Land Rover is very you.
Oh, you looked.
I did.
Well. I'll leave you to it. Say one for me.
I have to make a decision about Christmas. Tell me, do you think the king will be well enough to go to Sandringham?
I do. As a matter of fact, I think it would do him good.
So it's decided.
Will you be joining us too?
Me?
Of course not. Peter will be spending Christmas at home with his family.
I was only thinking of Papa. Given the choice, you know he'd never let him out of his sight.
Well, that's true. He's quite devoted to you.
And let me discuss it with Rosemary.
Oh, no. No, it's out of the question.
Why, Mummy? Let Peter discuss it. We did offer.
Oh, very well.
Look. The blossom's out.
Yes.
The sun is rising. What will this future hold? For us all. Aren't you coming? We can join Mummy and Papa for breakfast.
I'm afraid not. But I will always be by your side. No matter what.
Sorry, I'm not here. I was given strict instructions to remain out of sight. I just have to get to that room over there. Oh, and this is the only way. Your Royal Highness.
Well, I haven't seen a thing.
Thank you, sir.
I've been told that the Queen intends to make a speech at the reception afterwards.
A speech which nobody has seen and which
she's written herself.
It feels like she's planning a big announcement.
My father met with Anne to ask what she thought was in it, but she's as baffled as the rest of us. Then Anne rang Andrew and he went riding with the Queen, but you know Andrew. A complete blank. So if her intention was to set tongues wagging, she certainly succeeded.
Don't give it any further thought.
Yes.
Just think about the boys.
Thank you, darling.
You know, I loved you so much. So deeply. So painfully, too. It's over now. Be easier for everyone with me gone.
No, it won't.
It will. The admit it, you've had that thought already.
The only thought I've had since the moment I heard is regret.
That will pass.
No, it won't.
No, Charles. He didn't stay for lunch.
Couldn't wait to get away. I heard he doesn't eat lunch anymore.
Why ever not? How queer. Perhaps he wants to keep his figure.
How is he, Dickie?
He talks more to you than to anyone.
Well, I'm afraid it's now clear the Navy is not for him.
Yeah, I wasn't talking about his career.
She means matters of the heart.
Well, he comes to you with all of that. We get to read about it in the newspapers like everyone else.
Set against a background of raw emotion, there is some feeling that the royal family should be in London sooner, the focus of the nation's mourning.
It's hard not to look at this like a psychologist might. There's the country, like a sick, uncomforted child, and then there's the Queen, hiding away, cold and aloof, unable to mother the nation in precisely the same way as she was unable to mother us.
That is just not helpful now.
And were there any other requests?
Some beaches, perhaps.
There will, of course, be beaches along the way.
And water sports.
And noisy water sports.
And shopping.
Shopping?
It's possible some people might like to go shopping one day.
Who? Show of hands, would anyone apart from Diana like to go shopping? And the entire point of being on a beautiful yacht like this is that you can escape from hordes of people indulging in retail as recreation.
Me! I want to go shopping.
Me too.
Then we'll go shopping.
Nice speech, Granny.
Thank you.
Though surprisingly short. You sure you didn't forget half of it?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What do you think?
Lovely.
It's better than the beer cans Harold wanted to tie to the bumper.
Be kind to him. In many ways, it's harder being number two than number one. The system protects number one. Number two tends to...
go mad.
I was going to say, need extra care and attention.
Ma'am?
Ah, photographs.
Very good. Let's go inside. Come on.
Girls, if you're gonna have them, keep them down and shh. Be quiet.
Charles, Charles, it's Harry. Harry!
Oh. Can you remember where we parked?
No.
Serves us right for coming up to London. Look.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas. Oh my God, it's Princess Diana.
Thank you. Merry Christmas. Do you know what? Here, can you have some more of yours? You're selling out. Thank you very much.
Here's a pound. No more than that.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Give it.
Oh, yeah. Selling like hotcakes.
Here.
That's very generous. What's your name?
Catherine.
Kate's fine.
Say thank you to Kate.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Thanks. When are you going back?
To St Andrews.
Yeah.
Tomorrow. I'm looking at a couple of houses for next year.
Who? Have you decided who you're going to live with?
Fergus.
Of course.
And Olivia.
Nice.
There's this place on Hope Street which looks good. Big windows.
I like Hope Street.
But it's got four bedrooms, and there's just three of us. Unless you happen to know a fourth.
Well, were you thinking a boy or a girl?
Probably a girl, to keep things...
civilized.
Exactly. Would you consider it?
Is that an invitation?
Well, I would have to ask the others.
Of course.
But I'm sure they'll approve.